What's up, guys? We're about to get into a mod, but let me show you my yard real quick. Just 60 seconds. Check this out. So I got the all new gutters, right? I know you can't see crap. There used to be one on each side of the garage. Now there's one for everything. A mini that drop into the bottom. I just did this entire pipe yesterday and finished it today. 3 10-footers all the way out, kind of to the curb there, into the cracks. I'll show you in the brightness sometime. And I still got to lay the pipe along that side of the driveway. That'll be another time in light. But let's get to the fun stuff. Let's get to the mod. All right, at this point, most of you probably can guess what this is, given its size and its shape and its brand. I'm going to try something new.
You say, dude, you've tried so many intakes. I've tried almost all of them. I think I started with the racing line. I had the IE. I have the AFE. And I think I always forget like another one I've had. Racing line. I can't remember. Oh, look at this. APR always has the best packaging, guys. Let's see what we got. So, just aside from the point, I just like my tips, I want quiet, medium, loud. Get it? So, stock is my quiet. AFE is my medium. This is my loud for when I'm in the mood. So, woo! And, you know, like, I guess the truth is I kind of missed the noises when I finally got rid of the IE intake, and I wanted some more noise, but I didn't want to buy the exact same thing again, you know, that's even more boring. Like, I didn't want to buy another IE, and, you know, there's some things I didn't like about it, how it had a lot of leaks and it's sealed stuff and all that. So, I've always loved the look of this thing, so I've always secretly wanted to just try it out for a while, so it just kind of worked out. APR is a partner of the channel. No, I did not get this free, of course not, but I'm just disclosing, I did work with APR to get this piece here. Wow, the whole thing is just like in the bag, that's the whole thing. So we're gonna just get an instant exposure to like everything, I guess. Here we go. I'll give you a close up, dude. Check that, dude. Stock factory triple. Hell yeah. The AFE, I think, only has 2 instead of 3. This is even more solid. The filter's already installed. What? You don't have to do nothing, dude. Killer now. Yeah. It has your tube, if you can't see that, for your hose, you know. I need to use that thing right there for my hose that goes underneath. Little drain hole for the water. Let's get closer right under a little light. Try and really just soak it in. A really good look. I mean, looks good now. Every carbon I've ever had turns yellow after a while, but hey, it looks good now. I can't wait to use it. Check that out. That's going to be so loud. I've heard it's obnoxiously loud. That's why I'm going to run it. I want, you know, choices. How many times do I got to tell you? So let me show you the one I have now, and I'll get it uninstalled real quick. So I didn't even make a video on it. I just made a couple posts once, but they have different numbers. The main number is the same, of course. Make sure. Yeah, it's just different revs, but whatever. The car runs excellent. I got G22s and E23s, a mix. Anyway, the car runs excellent, and I'm not complaining. So there we go. We got the blue. Those are recent. Now, this is the intake that I run most of the time. I do enjoy the stock, bone stock intake sometimes. I never change out the elbow from what it is now, which is racing line. I've had a few. I've had the IE, I've had the racing line, and I've had Unitronic.
the racing line for me, it's, you're not going to notice the 1 horsepower difference between them, but the racing line was, for fitment, was the best fit. It just worked the best and had the best clearance. So that's why I just kind of chose that one out of all the available options. Now this AFE, they do sell a crappier one for less. This is like 500 or something. They sell a crappier one that's open, like your basic K&N. This is a little bit nicer. It has a little bit of nice scoop here to kind of take in all that air. Nice colorful thing there. I think the filter used to be more blue. I don't think it was white, but I could be wrong. I think it might have been blue. I don't know. I'll have to look at my old videos. So we can take off the hose that we talked about already. Then these things take 3 minutes to remove. You got your big screw here. This one is Sketch-O-Matic, Hell-O-Matic. You got to be super careful. Your quarter-inch ratchet back there, that's the hole that freaking stole my 6-inch, quarter-inch extension that I never found, and one of my deep-end 8s or 9s, I think, to be found in that hole. So I go very slow when I'm working this bolt, and I don't hold the ratchet from the back, which was evidently pushing the button to release it, and then you forget, lift it, socket falls. Oh, you are done, bro. So performance for this thing, I like it. It's excellent. The car is running incredible. You have this little hatch panel. You can go ahead and seal off if you want. I had to make it bigger, or else it's too floppy. I'm afraid it'll blow out. But you have a little secret hatch to get a little more air. And it's just a really nice design. I definitely love the single plastic tube and all that. It's really cool. But I want to try something different today. It's the one accessory that came with it. I'll have to go to manuals.apr to see what this is for later, some other time, if I have something, you know, loose. I don't know what it really would be. All right, let me make sure just that everything's ready. These are tight. I do like how it comes pre-assembled. I mean, they could have given it to him pieces and all these brackets and said, do it all. It's all, you know, nice and tight and professional. It's kind of nice just having someone else take care of it for you. All right. You see that thing right there? Yeah. I love the APR, actually. All right. Let me find where this sits and what the hell happens here. See if it even fits. My battery cable, too. I do have the battery cable problem. Okay. So this goes here. Where's the down one? Down there. I think I want to actually, for this particular piece, I need to move my battery cable. I want to adjust it a little, because it's really right there. It really wants to be there. I can move this out easily anywhere. So let me do a little move here. Okay, this was not that big a deal, and I don't want anybody to get worried about it. All I did was, the only thing really locked in is down here. I didn't take apart anything. All I did was lift this piece from here, tuck it over while watching carefully all my grounds and my other cables here, make sure I don't rip nothing. And all I did was just push it to the other side. Check this. Just to the other side of the tray, basically, is what it wanted. It was kind of out here. It's right where the intake wants to be. This should be good here. We'll do another test. In the bottom, my loud mouth intake, I'll have to call it. What else fits down here? Okay. Okay,
No, not bad. Let me inspect a little more. That's a pretty good fit. Okay, yeah. Nothing touching, but things are close. Good. As far as there won't be rattles. Oh, wow. That's pretty good. You know, you always freaking... You lean on it for a minute, and you, like, dent your freaking fins. I can turn it upside down. Duh. I'm gonna hide it. It's just bug and brand new. And I got this little press where I leaned on it for a minute. I'm gonna twist it secretly off camera. You guys will never know. Oh, except that I just told you. Let me get you some close-ups underneath. I'll try. And let's just look at the fitment on this thing. So the very first thing that a lot of people, and mostly me, forget when I get distracted is to put this hose on. So before I get into all this, which will make me forget about this, I'm gonna find that little nibbit. Nibbit? Yeah. Oh, perfect. I forgot. I was supposed to show you guys the fitment. One sec. Heck yeah. Oh, keep going, baby. Oh, it's in all the way. All right, that's good. That's good. Man. Okay, you guys get like mega spotlight now. So down here, let me see that. You got a little one down here. Let's see. It's in there. It's in there. It's not quite... Oh, I just haven't pushed it down all the way. I see. You know, you gotta... Can I click it? I got it. Yeah. So that's here. Note the clearances here. Wow, that's very precise. And it's... I'm very happy that they did all that. See, even if I have a non-standard clamp down there, it's still plenty of room. So I do like the shapes that they made here. On the battery, you can see it's kind of close. You can see how... Yep. My cable right there was interfering with that little outcrop, that little triangle right there. So I didn't have to move it even as much as I did. So we're all good there. I don't know. Let me see. See if I can give you a mega shot. I can't even see under there. But somewhere under there is the other clip. We'll go down here and look down the side a little bit. Look at that. And... where was the other? Let's see, one on the edge, one underneath, and one in front. Yeah, you can't really see, you can see a little clip down there maybe, a little rubber, but yeah, they all fit. Everything looks good. And down here, you have a little bit of gap, you know, for the tray and stuff, so it's not gonna vibrate or touch or rattle, you know. You don't want it touching, even, yeah, it'll seal better, yeah, right. All it'll do is just make noise. So this is perfect. This thing is gonna be loud, guys, ain't it? Woo! So, the only unfortunate thing, I hope it fits or I'm going to be one sad boy today. I hope that's a stock spot. I'm sure it is. I have to go get my OEM hose from the shed. I don't have any, in all my intake combos, I don't have any hose aftermarket that'll fit that to that, in a nutshell. The AFE is, you know, a whole molded piece. I can't use that. So I'm going to go to the shed. I'll be back. feeling alive. So it looks like I gotta buy a hose, so I'll be back with part two. The stock one just won't stay on. It just pops right off as soon as I try and mangle it into place, even with the clamp. So yeah, I'll buy a cheap hose and just so I can try this thing out. So part two will be when I get a hose and I can actually try it. All right, guys, we are picking up about a week later almost, and I do not have my inlet hose yet. All right, so what did we get here? Well, I sanded this too. No, I don't care about ruining it. This is not a very, I guess I shouldn't say that. This is an expensive intake, but compared to some of the other ones. And again, I'm buying this for functionality. I didn't buy it for looks. I don't care about that. But see, the whole question here is, I couldn't get this stock pipe to stay on this thing. Every time I tried to finish this end, it would pop off. So I actually took a heat gun at 1,000 and it didn't melt. And I just heated this whole rubber rim for a while, off the car, of course. The whole thing was off the car. And then I just tried to push it on, and it kind of seat fully, I believe, and the clamp. And then before I even tried putting it in here, right, I just tried to, like, bend the pipe off it just with, like, some medium pressure, and it didn't budge. So I think I finally got it on far enough just for it to function. I do have a better hose coming in a few days, but man, if I could try this now, I'd be super stoked. Looks like I can try it. Also wanted to show you what a closer look at the fitment while the filter's out. It's pretty good. I pushed down on all these little nubs with a screwdriver, as it's hard to get them to fully, you know, clip in. This one is just, you know, barely clipped in. It's in, but you know, you got to kind of push down. But again, I don't see any interferences or anything. It's actually pretty good. Even here, that clamp is just, it's 2-3 mil away from that carbon, so, you know, no issues there. And then around here, kind of goes under, doesn't seem to touch anything, I think we're good. So this clamp is, of course, tight. I did this in the office before I even brought it down and did all that testing. This clamp is not tight, but I do have this inlet fully seated properly, so all I gotta do is tighten that freaking clamp, and I can hear this frickin' intake after I put on the filter. Speaking of filters, this is Mr. AFE, and this is Mr. APR. Same exact height, it's just a rubber difference. Same height, but probably double the volume, I'd say, something like that, because you get more for less, what, you know, frickin' mathematics and all that crap. The bigger it is, much bigger it is, you know, it gets more square footage. And we do have the nice input here, and the same thing here, right there. APR's is, again, bigger. Look at that. Oh, there's a good shot right there. Mongo. Now, I'm not even saying that my car needs this much air. It doesn't. It doesn't even probably need this much air. It could run off the stock filter. But I'm just showing you, there is a pretty big difference in the filter size here. This thing is going to be loud. Nothing in sight, forever in flight. Follow those lines, we'll make it this time. Blurry street lights, work as a guide to memories that we'll make it tonight. Oh yeah, we'll make it tonight. Yeah. Guys, it's a little cold, but I'll just take my sunroof is open for some reason.
I'll just take you out just real quick to listen to a few noises. Kind of a funny school. You'd rather see something than darkness. The funny thing was, I was just finishing editing the video, about to like save it and upload it. And I just knew that if I did not put any kind of sound clip in here, everybody'd be pissed and everything. Let's see, I'm gonna close the sunroof. And I took it around the block once and listened a little bit. The AFE intake set and all the tools in my trunk. Just while I tested a day or two, make sure it's not gonna, you know, blow off, and then maybe the car wouldn't run without any intake at all. Sometimes, I'm not sure, so. Just for peace of mind for a day or two while I make sure this pipe isn't gonna pop off. You'll be able to hear the noises at the high speed, honestly, it's too windy. It's just kind of fast to go right now, you know, at night and stuff. I don't like to be doing that because there's a lot of cops out, so I can't show you too well. I just wanted to let you hear just a smidge. I don't even know if you could hear anything, honestly. But I can't wait to get more used to this. It isn't nearly too loud for me, suspected. It actually is quieter than the IE, I think. But, you know, I have to test it a few days and just, you know, see how it feels.
Fast, call it high speed. I've been working hard, yeah, I've been working nightly. If you think you'll win, ha, not fucking likely. I be taking shots, yeah, cold-blooded, icy. Watching numbers grow is what I call sightseeing. In the front row, run it up when they hype me. The following grows, they know how to ignite me. Call me CEO, I've been running shit right, see. And I ain't playing games, I create my own lane. Making pleasure out of pain, Turning losses into gains. I'm the boss, I'm making change. I've been rocking this exchange, Popping off and risking things. Gonna make a fucking name. I just wanna be famous. But I don't want that cheap fame. No, I'm not that vain. I just wanna be greatness.